Another gentleman, part of the extraordinary I Shouldn't Be Alive series, is Warren Macdonald. His lower body was trapped under a massive boulder on a remote Australian island, lost both legs as a result. He's a motivational speaker and author of A Test of Will, One Man's Extraordinary Story of Survival. There you see its cover. All the books mentioned tonight are available on Amazon.com. What happened?
What happened? I was in the wrong place at the wrong time, you could say. I'd gone to an island called off the North Queensland coast, back in Australia. Gone to do a hike, basically, along the length of the island.
By yourself?
Yeah, just some R&R. And at the end of the first day, I met a guy, a Dutch guy, that had gone over to the island on his own. And he was keen to climb to the top of Mount Bowen, the highest peak on the island. And I thought, do you know what? I think I've got time to do that. Let's do it. We'll team up. We'll do the climb. And I can still get back to the south end of the island and get off on the ferry. And we basically, you know, spent all day climbing up a creek bed. Pretty tough climb. There's no actual trail. And got to the point where I hesitate to say we were lost. We were geographically embarrassed, is the way I like to describe it. And set up camp for the night. And I, being an outdoors kind of guy, I needed to use the bathroom before going to bed. And I wanted to get as far away from the creek as I could. And I started climbing up a steep rock face. I got about 5 foot up and I heard a huge crack. And it was basically a piece of the wall broke out and landed in my lap. Yeah.
What did your friend do?
He heard me yell out and he was pretty quickly out of his sleeping bag, ran across the creek with the flashlight everywhere and just basically came upon this scene of me under this rock.
Wasn't able to do anything?
No, we tried for half of the night. We tried everything. Geert was in the bush, breaking out branches off trees, pulling out small trees. We basically broke every lever we tried and figured that that rock wasn't going anywhere. They told us later it weighed a ton.
So how'd you, what happened?
We decided that he would hike out. And I've got to tell you, I mean, I'd met the guy the day before and I don't think I've ever felt so lonely watching him walk away. And I knew that it was my ultimate test. You know, everything in my life up until that point was now going to come in. And
he went to get help?
Yeah.
How long were you alone?
In total, 45 hours.
How did they get the boulder off you?
Hydraulic jack, crowbars, wooden blocks. It took the rescue crew 2.5 hours, which in a way validated for me, there's always that feeling, have we done everything? Have we tried everything? Is there something we've missed? And watching those guys struggle to lift it.
And had to amputate your legs?
They did. They got me straight to hospital and explained that my legs had been so badly damaged that they were going to have to amputate that night. And
how much pain were you in?
Indescribable, really. I mean, you wonder how much pain can somebody withstand before you actually just die from pain, and that definitely was going through my mind.
You never passed out?
I didn't pass out until they lifted the rock off me.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you hallucinate?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I had, at one point, I imagined that a group of businessmen had explained to me how to basically will myself out from under the rock. And I tell you, I was devastated when I found myself still there. Couldn't believe it.
Carly, so what, I guess you don't go hiking anymore.
Well, that's not entirely true. It's interesting. People say the accident didn't slow me down. It actually sped me up. I climbed Mount Kilimanjaro 3 years ago using prosthetic legs.
With artificial legs.
Yeah. I've climbed El Capitan in Yosemite. My partner introduced me to ice climbing. It literally sped me up. I mean, I think I realized it was a big wake-up for me that life's pretty short and that we best make the best of it. And it's pretty much what I've been doing and trying to get others to do the same.
Insects were preying on both legs?
Yeah. Yeah, the paramedic tells me, Chip tells me that the ants were having a bit of a picnic when he turned up. I'd disturbed their nest, let's just say.
What did you learn from all this?
What did I learn? That we're infinitely more powerful than we think we are when you get pushed to that point. I think the biggest lesson I learned, though, was how we create our own reality. I think I always felt that to an extent. But after coming through this, I came away knowing it.
Extraordinary story, extraordinary book. Thank you.
Thanks, Larry.
Warren Macdonald. Whew. What a night. Les Survivorman Stroud is next. Don't go away.